everybody. We're out here in the pits of the National Hot Rod Association looking for cool cars. And you know I found one, right? We don't talk a lot of Competition Eliminator, but we got to talk more. Check out Rodger Brogdon's 66 Chevy Nova station wagon. Now, I know you guys know Rodger. Rodger has taken it to the next level with this amazing machine. Rodger, how did you dream up this immaculate conception?
Well, we wanted to build something different, okay? And you can't build anything much more different than a station wagon. But we raced one of these way back in the late 70s with my dad and my uncle in Super Stock L Automatic, a basic four-door 66 wagon with a 283 and a Power Glide. I said, well, if I take that to the ultimate level, that would be a really cool comp car.
And a Competition Eliminator always was this, like creativity and finding a car and turning into something that is much quicker than anybody expected. Be altered automatic, so basically carbureted pro stock engine with an automatic transmission, but nobody runs a station wagon. What has the reaction been to this car so far?
It's honestly, I've owned a lot of nice cars in my life. This is the most popular, sought after car I've ever had. People are on Facebook all the time telling me, I hope you bring it here, I hope you bring it there. It's really been a lot more popular than I thought it would be.
All right, so walk us around the car. We got shots of everything. Obviously, Southwest Performance, that's McGahey and his crew doing the power. They are very experienced in comp, but a transmission that most people are pretty familiar with.
Yeah, that's basically a 350 type GM transmission made by Mark Mickey. It's something that's really beefy, can hold up to this, because we tried a few other ones when we first put this together, and we could hardly get one run out of a transmission without breaking something, so we beefed that up. Overall, the whole car is nothing but a pro stock car, okay? It's 2 inches longer than the wheelbase. Everything on the car, on the top, this is the original top and the original quarter panels, okay? But they took a four-door and made it a two-door. So the front end and the doors and all that are carbon fiber, just like on the Pro Stock car.
It's like a 66 Nova Nomad.
Yeah, kind of. Yeah, it's really cool. The top's been chopped 3 inches, windshield laid back, 6 inches narrowed, the whole car was, and it's been stretched about 15 inches.
Let's walk around the back. Yeah. I want everybody to see around the back. Come on, guys, because this thing, the attention to detail, this is where it just looks super cool. This is so out of the ordinary for a comp car. Everybody loves it. But is it competitive? Will it be competitive? I hope so, because I want to see more.
Yeah, it will be. We just got a bunch of new bugs in it because of the new car, and really hadn't had the time to work on it like we should. Our testing and tuning is at the track because I got so much going on with the Pro Stock car, but we've been having a lot of issues with the transmission not shifting and this and that, but it's. I think they figured it out this morning, some kind of back feed through the grid or something. So we're going to go out there and give it our best shot. But talk about the detail of the car. You can just look at all the airbrush work and all. And even painted the 66 Chevy 2's had the little drip rail around the top. If you can see it up here, they actually hand painted all that all the way around the whole car. But, It is. It's not missing a thing, Joe. When I first got the Jerry shop, I just sat down on the little bucket and just looked at the thing from front to back for 45 minutes. Then I understood why it took him 2 years to build it. But Dan at the shop and all the guys, they did a hell of a job, and I couldn't be more proud of our car.
Jerry Haas, that is, and he's very proud of the car as well. And where you found it, I think that's a big part of the story, right? Like, this isn't something you call an order. You had to find the body, and then you had to tell Jerry what you wanted. Tell us about that part of it.
Well, we when I first decided to start doing it, he said, well, where do you find one of those? I said, well, I got two at my house right now, but I really don't want to use them because I'm building a baby clone of this and to run Super Stock A Modified next year. But he actually found one in the woods. And I'm glad he didn't show me the pictures of it before he started, because I would have told him, no, we got to have something different. But it was all the parts were there. That was the main thing, because they could use a lot of the things they needed to make a mold off of this or whatever. So, yeah, but he drug it out of the woods.
Amazing. And for our listeners out there, you run Pro Stock, but you really consider yourself a comp racer and have done a lot for the comp racers, especially in Division 4, and you want more people to appreciate cars like this and Competition Eliminator. You got a chance to talk directly to them. Why?
I think the nostalgia part, going all the way back to like the Modified Eliminator days and where Competition Eliminator came from and move up. There's a lot of great classes that guys can take cars like this, old body styles, and just build, and they're very competitive. You know, it's not that this car's not competitive. When we get it right, I think it'll be a 75 under car. So, but I just, you know, everybody's car out there looks a lot the same, okay? And that's all I'm gonna say, but I just think the creativity, because comp's all about creativity, you know it? Look, there's four cylinders, all the way up to 800 cubic inch engines, I mean, automatics, Lincos. I mean, it's all about creativity, and guys need to use their imagination and build more cars like this. I actually heard of one guy's building like I think it was 75 or 76 model Vega to run H altered with it, so. You know, maybe it's catching on a little bit. Hopefully it does.
Hey, let's see in the cockpit. You're a big man, Roger. You had to build a big car.
It's technique. You know?
Yeah, we wanted to see this. This is how we'll end it off. Obviously, we normally
got to point this out when you get to look at it.
Yes. Look at the dash. Look at the D. Don't miss Roger getting in, though, guys.
Yeah.
Don't miss Roger getting in.
Everybody knows about the old Chevy 2. The speedometers used to go to 110 miles an hour. Or maybe 120, but I think 110. Mine goes to 200.
There it is. Exactly. Roger, climbing in. 66. Nova Wagon. There you go. You look very at home. You got your Max Pappas steering wheel. Look at this guy. This looks awesome. You have a lot of space in here.
Oh, yeah. You could probably ride over here, you know.
Is that an offer?
Sure, sure.
We would love to do that one day. One day, you got to put a little passenger seat for me. It wouldn't have to be big. I would do it.
Yeah, it'd be real kind of tiny.
I am kind of tiny. Everybody knows that. Hey, perfect for a race car driver. I'm soliciting right now if anybody wants me. Roger,
He's
a very tall man.
I've seen him losing out there, yeah.
He just lost this weekend, but we don't want to timestamp it. But okay. Yes, he was beaten by a TV reporter.
This weekend, right?
The most recent time.
Okay, good.
Sorry, Alan. just the facts. But Roger, congratulations on your creativity and your willingness to do something different, and that's why we're here. We want to show that this is what's happening in the NHRA. We love Competition Eliminator, but I agree with you. Breaking out of the box, and you certainly have, with a car that looks a lot like a box. Roger, thank you so much.
Oh, thank you, Joe. I appreciate everybody. Thank you very much.
And that's why you come out into the pits here at the NHRA.